Einen wunderschönen herzlich willkommen zurück zu einer weiteren Folge von Lamplight City. Wir haben mit der Witwe von dem Abgeordneten gesprochen. Und wir sind da noch nicht fertig. Wir haben hier noch was in der grünen Lilly zu tun. Ich gehe aber erstmal vorher ins Kaffeehaus. Denn wir haben ja einen Hinweis bezüglich Ruby bekommen und die Bedienung wollte da mit der was machen.
Pardon, miss.
How can I help you, sir?
This friend of yours, Ruby, did she know an MP named Percival McDonough?
I'm not sure. Ruby knows a lot of men.
Is that so?
Well, no, I don't mean... It's just... Oh, damn it all, me and my big mouth. She'll have my guts for garters now.
It's all right, no one's in trouble. But I think I'd like to speak with Ruby. Could you tell me where I can find her?
No. You see, she moves around quite a lot. Never in the same place for more than a night or two.
Right. I think she's given us a clear picture of what Ruby does for a living. Normally, I'd be all for pressing this girl more until she cracks. But I like her. I think we'll be able to find Ruby without causing her more discomfort.
Well, thank you for the information. You've been very helpful.
Okay.
I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you, sir.
Na, dann bin ich mal gespannt. Was hat er notiert? Ruby finden. Okay. Gab's hier irgendwo ein Feuer? Mir fällt da gerade was ein. Entweder hier.
Completely ruined.
Nee.
At least having a heater down.
Ja, probier mal hier.
I wonder.
If this actually works, I'll eat my hat.
Hitze. Okay. Liebste Mary, Worte können das von mir empfundene Bedauern, den Kummer darüber, wie ich mich gestern Nacht verhalten habe, nicht fassen. Ich hoffe zutiefst, dass du mir verzeihen kannst und dass ich dieses Monster nie wieder herauslasse. Percival. Mary.
Well, I'll be damned.
What was that you were saying about eating your hat?
Yeah, well, the joke's on you, Miles, because I no longer have a mouth.
It doesn't seem to stop you from talking all the time, though. In any case, this is certainly an interesting revelation.
Yeah. Mary. Wir könnten mal nochmal.
Hello again, Mr. Fordham.
Mit ihr sprechen. Ich habe aber gerade irgendwie den Faden verloren bei den ganzen vielen Charakteren, die gerade hier eine Rolle spielen.
Can we talk some more, Mrs. McDonough?
I suppose so, yes.
Do you know anything about this letter?
I'm afraid I don't have my spectacles. What is it?
The coroner found it in your husband's pocket. He gave it to me because he thought it was blank. But after you told me about your husband's propensity for writing secret messages, I decided to try exposing the paper to heat. Allow me to read it to you. Dearest Mary, words cannot express the regret and sorrow I feel for how I acted last night. I swore to myself I would never harm you again after the last time, but I have failed us both. It is my deepest hope that you can forgive me and trust that I will never allow this monster out again.
I see.
Affäre.
May I have that letter, Mr. Fordham?
I'm afraid I have to keep it for now. It's evidence.
I suppose that that does make sense.
Mrs. McDonough, did Percival mistreat or abuse you?
He wasn't a bad man, Mr. Fordham. I wouldn't have married him if he was. It's just the stress of his responsibilities that sometimes oppressed him. I would try and offer comfort, soothe his nerves, but there were a few instances where he lost control of his passions.
Did he ever hit you?
He did.
How many times did this happen?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe two or three? You don't exactly count these things.
What a bastard. Maybe it serves him right for getting shot.
Thank you for your candor, Mrs. McDonough.
Can we please talk about something else?
Those are all the questions I have for now, Mrs. McDonough.
All right, Mr. Fordham.
Aber es passt nicht mit dem Justice Killer zusammen. Okay, sie ist jedenfalls erledigt, ne? Ups. Rausgeklickt aus dem Fenster. Sie ist aber immer noch da. Habe ich gespeichert? Oh, irgendwie wird das gerade hier zu... Mal gucken, ob wir mit ihm sprechen können. Ich vermute, hier haben wir auch noch eine Spur.
Ja,
haben wir nicht. Aber hier vielleicht. Nee, haben wir nicht. Okay. Hier ist eigentlich auch alles erledigt. Tja, ich glaube...
Well, hello there, handsome. Welcome to the Gilded Lily. Come over here and tell me what kind of pleasure it is you're looking for.
I'm afraid I'm here for business, not pleasure.
Oh, well, that's just a shame, isn't it?
I'm Miles Fordham, private investigator. And you are?
You can call me Serafina. I'm in charge of this establishment.
You won't mind if I take a look around or ask you some questions?
As long as you keep to the front room, you can do whatever you like. Beyond that, you're gonna have to pay.
Maybe it's best if you leave this part out when you tell Adelaide about the case later. I'm not too familiar with places like this, but I believe that's where the fun happens, if you've got the crowns for it.
Das Ding sieht richtig realistisch aus.
Oh, my virgin eyes! What a charming statue. Wouldn't she get cold fetching water in that state of undress? Looks nervous. Wonder if this is his first time. You certainly won't find art like that at the National Gallery.
Was passiert, wenn man da hinten hingeht? Oops.
I think that room is reserved for paying customers. We won't be able to get back there without a good reason.
Okay, dann los.
May I ask you a few questions, Serafina?
Of course you may, but I can't guarantee the answers will be free.
Hat sie. Ha. Richtig.
Did you have a man named Hannibal Kirkland as a client?
I make it my practice not to learn the names of any customers here, Mr. Fordham. I hate to disappoint anyone who comes through those doors, but discretion is paramount in this business.
Well, at least you know you can trust these women with your secrets.
Mm-hmm.
Do you by chance have a girl named Ruby in your service?
Ruby? Yes, she's one of our newest girls. She's not in any sort of trouble, is she?
Not at all. I merely wanted to speak with her.
Well, she should be in the dressing room. If you go through the rear door and follow the hallway down, it's the last door on the left.
I see. Okay. Thank you. Did you know Percival McDonough?
The politician? I knew who he was, but never met him personally.
He was seeing Ruby, wasn't he?
Not regularly, no. In fact, his first and only visit with her was yesterday.
Were you aware that he was murdered shortly after that?
I had no idea. How terrible.
Yes, it is terrible. This means she's lost a potential repeat customer.
This is a lovely establishment you have. And such a nice name, too.
Thank you, my dear. It wasn't always called the Gilded Lily, though. We were formerly known as Le Maison des Tolérances.
What inspired the name change?
Ah, that's a bit of a long story. Not worth getting into.
How long have you been operating?
Going on 25 years. Business has been good. There's a reason this is the world's oldest profession, you know.
So, how did you get into this business?
Like many of the other girls, it was the best of some bad options. I had no interest in being beholden to a husband. I may be a fallen woman, but better to fly and fall than to have your wings clipped.
Do you enjoy the work?
It's a job like any other, Mr. Fordham. There are good days and there are bad days. But my girls are my family. We take care of each other. I couldn't ask for anything better.
Do you know anything about the Justice Killer?
I'm afraid not, dear. I don't normally associate with killers.
Are you sure you don't know anything? He's the reason I'm here.
Well, I can assure you I know nothing about your murderer. If the trail has led you here, it's surely just coincidence.
Yeah, she seems awfully certain of that. It's a good thing we don't believe in coincidences.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for your time.
Of course, my dear.
Es gab ja schon mal einen Fall, ich glaube es ist sogar ein Hercule Poirot, ein Agatha Christie-Fall, wo es mehrere Mörder gab, die so getan haben, als wären sie einer. Ja, nur mal so, also. Ah, jetzt können wir hier hinten durchgehen, gut. Vielleicht ist das hier auch der Fall, wenn das alles eine Familie ist, ne?
Oh, hello. Did Serafina send you back here for me?
Yes, but not for the usual reasons. I'm a private investigator. My name is Miles Fordham. Ruby, I presume?
Yes, that's right. What do you need from me?
Just some information.
Well, I'll do my best.
Mm-hmm.
The girls here don't get much in the way of a dressing area. Still, something is better than nothing, I suppose. Lily, 1809 to 1843. I wonder what happened to her.
Moment. Stift. Warum? Das ist das erste Mal, dass da irgendwas mit zeitlichen Angaben kommt. Warte mal.
Damn shame to be cut down in the prime of your life. Believe me, I know.
Warum kommt... Oh, nee, ne?
Damn shame... Damn...
Ah... Oh. Da, 1843 und 1809. Das muss irgendwas eine Bewandtnis haben. Vielleicht die Mutter von jemandem oder so.
That's a nice locket for being such a cheap piece of jewelry.
Das ist ein Code. 3132213 habe ich mir aufgeschrieben.
No lilies? Seems like a missed opportunity. Cut down in her prime.
Mm-hmm.
I'm guessing this is where most of the girls keep their personal belongings. Doesn't seem to offer much in the way of privacy.
Okay, los, dann reden wir mal mit ihr.
The girls here don't get...
Ja, mit ihr, nicht mit dem Spiegel.
So, Ruby.
Yes?
Das ist eine Adrette, ja.
Did you ever have a client named Hannibal Kirkland?
No, that name doesn't sound familiar. Sorry.
Do you know Ennis Bowditch?
Bowditch? Didn't think I'd be hearing that name again.
As I understand it, he was seeing your friend, the serving girl at the ruined coffee house.
Yeah, that's right. Annabelle. She broke things off with him a while ago, though.
So she said. Did you ever know him to be violent?
Violent? The bastard nearly beat Annabelle's brains in once. Why do you think she chucked him?
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
At least she had the good sense to get rid of him.
Perhaps we should go confirm this newly discovered fact with Annabelle.
Did you ever meet a man named Burley Cause?
No, I never met him, but one of the other girls had him as a client. I remember because she was laughing about his name. He wasn't very burly, if you get my meaning.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Are you familiar with Reggie Willingham?
Oh, him? He had to be banned from here.
Really? What happened?
He got way too rough with one of the girls. She ended up shy a few teeth.
What?
Dear Lord.
Yeah, apparently he wasn't too fond of boundaries. Good riddance to him, I say.
Were you aware that Mr. Willingham was murdered?
What? Oh, well, now I feel terrible for saying good riddance. I meant...
I think I know what you meant, Ruby. It's fine.
Is it me, or is there a pattern starting to emerge here?
Meine Ahnung kommt hier gerade zu tragen, ne?
You met recently with Percival McDonough, is that right?
How did you know that? I thought he was meant to keep those sorts of things private.
He had your name written down in his calendar.
And you found me here based on that?
Well, I am a detective.
Suppose that's true. Anyway, yes. I only met him the one time. There wasn't anything remarkable about him. After we finished, he got all emotional about his wife, but I could hardly understand what he was saying. I hate it when they cry afterwards.
That's a rather nice portrait. Who's the subject?
Oh, that's Lily. Before my time. Serafina knows loads about her. even changed the name of this place in her honor. You might try asking her if you want to know more.
How long have you been in this business?
Only a few months now. Used to work at a kitchen, but then they brought in some of those new automated machines.
Ah, sadly familiar story.
At least this profession isn't in any danger of being made obsolete by steam tech. Cold steel can never replace a warm touch.
Da hat sie recht.
Let's just hope that's true.
Have you heard of the Justice Killer?
No, I don't believe so.
He's a serial murderer who's killed 5 victims, mostly men from Chumley.
Oh dear, that sounds dreadful. Is that what you're investigating?
It is. Do you know anyone who might have some information about him?
I don't. Sorry I can't be more help.
I'll just leave you to it then.
Thanks, love.
May I ask you a few questions, Seraphina?
Of course you may, but I can't guarantee the answers will be free.
Could you tell me about the young lady in the portrait hanging in the back room?
Ah, that's Lily Peterson. She was a wonderful woman and a great friend.
What happened to her?
It's a rather tragic story, Mr. Fordham. I'd rather not go into too much detail.
Doch.
The short version is this. She was with a client who got very carried away. She was able to defend herself enough to mortally wound the bastard, but the damage had already been done. The girls and I decided among us that we would rename this establishment in her honor. Some days it's still hard to believe she's gone. I haven't even been able to get rid of her box of things.
I'm very sorry for your loss, Seraphina.
Ah, thank you, dear. It was especially awful given Lily's past. Her sister died at the hands of her own husband some 16 years ago.
Okay.
Some people just can't escape tragedy, no matter how far they run.
Huh. Something tells me these deaths are significant. It might be a good idea to learn as much as we can about Lily Peterson.
Thank you for your time.
Of course, my dear.
Okay, es wird spannend gerade. Die Frage ist nur... wo wir den Code benutzen können. Warte mal, wir sollten erstmal zum Kaffeehaus nochmal gehen. Sie hat uns hier noch was zu erzählen.
Begging your pardon, miss.
How can I help you, sir?
I spoke with your friend Ruby. She told me something quite disturbing.
What was that?
She said that Ennis had fits of violence, and that the reason you ended your relationship was because he hit you.
She tell you that? That was my secret to tell, not hers. I thought we were friends.
It's obvious she cares about you and was worried about your well-being.
Well, it hardly matters now Ennis is dead, does it?
But is it true? Did he raise his hand to you?
Yes, it is true. As I said before, something changed in him. I have no idea what, but I had to get away.
I see. Thank you for your honesty. I'm sorry you had to experience what you did. I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you, sir.
Vielleicht eine neue Droge, die er umherzieht? Das ist eine gute Frage. Nun gut, ich mache ein Folgenpäuschen. Wir sehen uns dann in der nächsten Folge wieder. Vielen Dank fürs Zusehen und bis dahin, euer Firefox.